5 slot during your precious time. So, first of all, let me introduce myself. I'm Ram Singh, and I started my journey 3 years back to the DCS, to IT company, and since last 2 years, I'm working in Drupal. And today, we will be talking about Drupal 8, mobile in its DNA. Okay. So, we will cover how Drupal is a mobile-friendly platform. So prior to that, we will just cover some facts why we are emphasizing on the word mobile, and why every company's website is going from mobile and then for tablet and then for desktop. Why this approach is important? Okay. So there are a lot of facts regarding growth factor in mobile. The one which is latest that Google has declared in the last May that Google search in mobile surpasses the desktop time. So this is the I think we start our surfing, web surfing from Google only. So this is the most important fact which we can see in the growth of the mobile. Okay. So next one is there are a lot of capabilities which you will get in small screen devices and which you won't get in the normal desktop, okay? Such as GPS, video images, and all. In this list, it doesn't end. There are a lot of factors which we will get in a small device. And if you can see, I am operating my presentation with mobile only. So there are lot of capabilities in a mobile you will get, and there are lot of apps you will be getting in a mobile that you won't get in a normal desktop. And third thing, if you see from the developer and from the designer perspective, you can see if we go with this approach, we need not to concentrate much on design. Okay, we can arrange our blocks in the vertical section, and we can be focused on more important data. Okay, and then we going forward in the tablet, we can just introduce little bit of design. As you can see, I introduce the design in my two of the blocks. Okay, and going for desktop for the large screens, we can just introduce our least important data. Okay, so in this case, if we reduce our width from 1300 to 320 or up to maximum 700. We will be more focused on the most important data which we want to show to our customer. Okay. So, keynote of race which happened in Chicago in March 2011, what he said is, if he were to start Drupal 8 from the scratch, he will develop it for small screens and then he will come for the desktop. Okay. So from that onwards, he appointed John Elvins as a lead of mobile initiative, and here we are with the Drupal 8 with lot of features which Greens would have dreamt at that time, and maybe more than that. Okay. So responsive web design, it's not only approach, it's a strategy of saving money. Okay. As I have shown in my slide, how we can approach building a base for a mobile and then we will go for a desktop, we save lot of money. So let's see how Drupal 8 is mobile friendly. So there are a lot of factors: responsive themes, responsive images, mobile administration, HTML5 friendly. Then ultimately these factors are leading to front end performance and SEO, and then web services. Okay. So all these factors make Drupal not only a mobile friendly, but it's a mobile first CMS. All these 5 factors. Then we will cover now individual factors and we'll see. So first factor of the mobile in Drupal 8 is the responsive themes. So all the themes in the core and the base themes which are provided in the Drupal, they are all are mobile friendly. You need not to worry about the mobile design. When you install the Drupal and just in Mozilla press Shift, Control and M, you will see the mobile view. And all your horizontal blocks will be arranged vertically, automatically. They will flow to vertical direction, and your main menu will be collapsed to a button. Okay, you need not to worry about all these things are there in Drupal 8 code. Okay, and the very important aspect as of performance and as of SEO wise, I'll see that responsive images. We normally used to neglect this factor, but let's see how responsive images, why it is important. You are a normal web page. In that web page, images cover almost 70% of the data usage. Okay, so it is wasting lot of bandwidth of the customer and lot of, and wasting a time also. So we have to think some solution, and that solution which was implemented and it is brought in the Drupal 8 core only. So for one thing, when we say responsive images, it's not that the images will just collapse to a width of 320. It is not only that. It is not only the case of fluid image. But it is, there are another two cases which we need to keep in mind while developing the responsive images. Okay. So first case is device pixel ratio. So your different resolution image devices should have images as per their resolution of the screen and art direction. So I'll just show the diagrammatical illustration of all these three cases prior to we'll go to the technical aspect. So this one. So if you can see, this is the normal, we can say that it's normal, come to the first thing in our mind what responsive images will be, then it should squeeze to the screen width. Okay. But apart from this, there are another two cases. First thing is, if we go from 1x devices to 3x, there should be a different resolution of image. Okay. And then we can see our direction. Here, what factor I need to explain is, if you can see, my desktop image is having clouds and a rocket. Okay. But in my important data in the desktop is only the rocket. Okay. So in mobile, I can just show the rocket so that it should be focused on the important data. So all these three factors, how we can implement is, we need to tell the browser regarding the width of image and which image we need to load in the mobile and which in the desktop and what is the resolution of the image. Okay. So let's see what your normal web browser know till now. So your browser knows about the viewport, okay, in which the customer is going to open your website. Your browser knows about the screen density, is it 1x, is it 2x, but your browser don't know the image dimension, rendered size, and which image to render in case of art direction. Okay, so but when we see our developer, what he knows about image dimension, he knows about rendered size, but and he knows about the which image to be rendered in mobile and desktop. Okay, so these three four to five tags which will help us in rendering the responsive images: picture tag, source, then media attribute, sizes attribute, and then source set attribute. So let's see how we can implement. Through the source set, we can just pass a set of images, okay, and we can specify the width of these images. Like my image 1 m1x is having 736 pixel, image m2x is 1100 pixel image, and sizes is the viewport width which image is going to cover in your screen. So my this image will be covering 100% of the viewport, full screen. Okay. So if we need to place these attributes into the source tag, we need to implement into those. Okay. So if we want a different set of images for mobile, for desktop, for tablet, we will just introduce different sources for tablet and for desktop, and through that we can render different sizes. I want 30% of the width screen to be covered in desktop, and I want 50% of the screen to be covered by image in tablet. So I can just pass those attributes through the sizes, and I can have different sources for the different devices, and through media query I can just pass the width of the screen. So,
so what do we do in the full screen itself? You can resize, right? So in the desktop, if you say 30 percentage, and if you resize the browser or resize this thing, so yeah. How do you?
So in desktop, it will be covering 30% of your width. When you shrink the screen, it will cover 50%. When it comes to tablet attribute, when it just pass this 1024 pixels. And going forward, if we stretch more like 737 pixel, it will start covering your 100% of the view.
So depending on these attributes, it will automatically...
Yeah, depending on these attributes. We need to cover all these source sets through the picture tag. On top of all these attributes, we need to implement our picture tag. And there are questions around the community that if some browsers want to support the picture tag and all, we have alternative for that fallback image. And image source set, we can just mention about our source set of fallback image. So now the question comes here is, okay, I'll just cover the, okay. Now if you can see, what are browser know? Our browser know about the image dimension, okay? Through source set, we have defined the image, dimension of the image. Is it 737 pixel or 1100 pixels? Then we have mentioned about the rendered size, about how much it is going to cover, our image, how much viewport it is going to cover. Then we can say, during the art direction case, we can just specify the different source sets. I want different image for mobile, I want different image for desktop and tablet. So our browsers know all these factors. But the question comes here is, if we need to implement these things, we have to make so many images and here the cost will actually increase. But in Drupal 8, we need not to worry about these two cases. When we have different resolution images, we need not to worry about it. Drupal out of the box provides you some modules. Let's see. Drupal out of the box, it will provide you breakpoint, responsive images, and image time module. And during the art direction use case, we have to bring image replace module from the contributor community. So prior to that, we will just speak about breakpoints. What breakpoints are? It is very much similar to media queries, and it is having, apart from media queries, it is having another metadata as well. As you can see, it is having my label, then labels, and then media query, then machine name, and it is having weight and multiplier. Through multiplier, you can specify the different resolution of the image, different resolution of the screen, media query, based on media query. So other thing is that on top of this configuration, we need to mention in a YML file. You can specify either in theme or module. Theme name dot breakpoint YML file or module name dot breakpoint dot YML file. On top of this, we have breakpoint module, which will keep eye on all these breakpoint groups, and it will keep eye on the screen width also. Okay, so it helps in sharing the one theme's breakpoint with another theme's breakpoint or another module breakpoint. So that is why we can implement breakpoint in our theme. And we can call this breakpoint in replace in responsive image module also as well. So we will see how Drupal 8 is helping. I'll just open video of demo one. So prior to that, we have this image, okay, implemented in one of the site, and I want different sizes images in tablet and in mobile. I don't want to render my 1400 pixel image to be rendered in mobile. So I'll just show how we need to do in Drupal. So we'll go to configuration. We'll add one image type for mobile. So this is just, I am entering the name of that image type, mobile 736 pixel. And after that, we need to add effect to that image. I will just scale that image, and I will add one effect to that image type, that my width should be 736 pixel. For this image style, I am having width only 736 pixel. So as you can see, I have added one image style, and one effect is added to that image type. So similarly, I have added for desktop and for tablet different image styles. So another thing, we will go to responsive style images. And prior to that, I'll just tell that in my theme, I have set breakpoints, okay, as per the requirement. And that breakpoints we will be rendering in responsive image type. So I am building one responsive image case 1. and this is the breakpoint group and this fallback image. So in breakpoint group you can see lot of other breakpoint groups are available, and I have selected one rainbow, which is my theme. And I just breakpoint module will just get those configuration and display over here. So for desktop I am going to try to this just say there are two things we can do in responsive image. We can just specify a single image for that screen, or I can just specify multi image for that screen if we want sets of the images. Okay, so we will just see first in this demo, we will just see only a single image game, single image use case. So for this single for this width, I'm going to define my image style will be desktop 1400 pixel. For this much breakpoint, my image style will be 736 tablet 104, and for mobile my image style will be mobile 736 pixel, and I will define my fallback image as a desktop. I have just saved it, and now you can see my responsive image case 1 is saved. And I'll just open content type. I have made this the responsive image 1. So I'll just attach this responsive image style to my content type. So I'll go to the manage display of my content type, and banner image I will make formatted as a responsive image, and in the settings of that image field, I'll just select the responsive image case 1. So as you can see, I have opened the image in another browser, and my screen width now is 1036 pixel. So I'll just open image in new tab, and my image width is 1400 pixel. I'll just shrink the screen, and the image width is 1024, and now my image width is 737 pixels. So as you can see, I have different images for different breakpoints. Okay. And what we did nothing, we just uploaded one. It's just like one time investment. We just need to define the image style. We just need to define the responsive image type based on our image type and the breakpoints, and then we need to call those responsive image type into our managed display of content type. So we will get different sets of images for this one. Let's see the use case 2. For this, I am using simulator of Chrome. Okay. So as you can see, in Apple iPhone 6. I have the banner image, and when I change to 6 plus, the same banner image is rendering. And there is another thing I need to highlight, that another second image, this one, it's rendering as a 100, it's taking full screen viewport. What I define? I'll define another image type, mobile 1100 pixel. I can use tablet as well. The one which I defined as a 1024, it won't matter much, but just for this example and demo, I've defined another image type with 1100 pixel. And to differentiate between mobile 736 pixel and mobile 1100 pixel, I will just add another effect, desaturation effect. So I've already added scale with 1100, and I'll just add desaturate, which will just make my image black and white, just to differentiate between two images. So here I'm adding another image, responsive image style, in which desktop and tablet I'm using the same image style. And for mobile, I'm changing my sizes attribute to 50, and I'm selecting two sets of the images. One is 1100 pixel and one is 736 pixel. So I have two images in this case, banner image and the body image. And I've called responsive image case 1, case 2a and 2b. For the for banner image I have called 2a and for body image I have called 2b. So let's reload the page. One thing we can notice, the body image got shrinked to 50% width of the screen. So from with the sizes attribute, we can just adjust our viewport of the image, how much it is going to cover in the screen. And when I shift to iPhone 6 Plus, my image is now black and white. It means it is rendering 1100 pixel image for mobile. And one thing you can notice here, my another image, it is not getting black and white because it is rendering responsive image case 2A only. Because it is covering half the viewport and it can go with the 737 pixel also. It need not to be 1100 because if we see the half of that, if it is covering half of the width of the screen, we can go with the 737 pixel. So it is all browser is deciding which image to be given to be rendered in this case. So now we will see a demo of art direction. I just explained about art direction, what it is. I want different images for different devices. So here, as you can see, I'm having DrupalCon. I'm using DrupalCon Asia image. And what is the important data in my this image only? Can anyone tell what is the important data I want to just highlight in this image? What is the important message I want to pass? Yeah, DrupalCon Asia. So I can just skip with these things because this much width of the screen, I'm not able to see the date and I'm not able to see the most important data, right? So let's see how we can do it. We will enable that module, contributed module, image replace, and I'll add one another image style, and I'll get responsive image in this list because I have enabled the responsive image module. So I've just defined that if this is the image style of my image, it should be replaced by another image in small device. So as you can see, in responsive image case 3, I will go with the desktop 1400 pixel. In tablet, I will go with the default tablet. But in mobile, I will use the mobile art direction image style, which I just added. So in responsive image content type 3, I need to do little bit tweaking in mobile and field. So for desktop image banner field, I need to give my image replace case. Like if in desktop I am having this image. So in desktop if I am having this image, so in mobile which image should be rendered as a counterpart of desktop banner image. So as you can see, I have defined two image fields, desktop banner image and mobile banner image. So I'll just tell through this manage field that if desktop banner image is taking mobile art direction use case, it should be replaced by mobile banner image. Okay. So I'll just go to manage display and hide my mobile banner image because I don't need it. And in desktop banner image, I'll define the image responsive image style case 3. Now I'll shrink my screen. When it just passed 737 pixel, my image is rendering on different image. I've added two images for that content, for that node, for this node.
Well, the image is already preloaded because as you're resizing the screen, I can see that it replaces the image immediately. Are the images already in the client or are those retrieved as you are resizing?
No, we need to resize it.
Yeah, but I mean, are all the images preloaded?
Yeah, all the images are preloaded.
So in that case, it's using more bandwidth.
What?
In that case, it's using more bandwidth.
No, actually, all these images will be cached, right? So it's just, we need to render the cached image.
So in the initial load, it does load all the versions?
So it will cache those all the images. Your browser will decide based on the use case which image to get. So it will get only that particular image. It won't get all the images.
Okay.
It will decide at the prior moment, and then it will see, okay, this image will be the best. It will call to that image and it will get back. So these were the demo regarding responsive image style. So as you can see, in Drupal 8, we have to just do some initial configurations, and we need not to worry about all the different images. We should not forget Drupal 7 also. So these two modules we can implement, and contributed modules we can implement, and we can have these effects on in Drupal 7 also. So I think I'm making some little bit boring, so I'll just go a couple of slides with some masala kind of thing.
Okay, before that, let's find that we can find the image size and then we can approach two different images.
Yeah.
But what we can do when client is updating the images,
yeah,
if we have a mobile version and we have desktop version, and client is updating some images, so we can't restrict client to approach some other images, right? two different size images or something. So can we handle that?
There is one crop effect. So if something is defined that we are going to just squeeze our image, like in my case, I just need to squeeze my image, I need to cut the outer part. So I can define crop effect in that as well.
So it means we should provide some third party tool to client?
No.
Then how client is going to crop the image?
No.
Or our tool is going to decide it?
In Drupal, I'm adding image styles, I'm adding scale effect, I'm adding desaturation. You can see the crop effect also will be. This is just if we are, I would suggest if we are pretty much sure that my image should be cropped with this much space only, with this much width only, then only we should go. Otherwise, we should upload two different images. Just we are uploading one desktop image, we will upload one mobile image.
That's the issue. It means we should ask client to upload two different images.
Yeah, if that is the case, we need to. Because we actually want two different images to be run. But we are pretty much sure that if we have to cut this image from this much width, we can use that effect, crop effect.
Okay.
So if I am having, like, I can give an example, if I am having this water bottle image and I am just rendering my text apart from that, okay, so I know that my other water bottles will also be using the same image width.
Right.
So I can just cut that, I can just add one crop size, and I can just render my
image. So it means when client is updating these images,
yeah,
we are not sure that how much image is going to,
yeah, that's right. We need to be pretty sure, yeah. But if we are pretty much sure, I would suggest go with the crop effect. That is what, like, we need not to worry in that case. We just have to upload one image and it will crop for the mobile.
If the client has already defined where to cut it, then it's better, you can use a crop, right?
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's better for them to...
Or upload it different. I did not read up this. You can just see one boy and girl just went to a date, and boy's boss called and he has to go to office just for redirecting one road. Okay, and this happened with my most of the friends. I need not to name his hair only. And but I think Drupal 8 brings a new ending for this comic. Okay, for these small edits, we can just edit the mobile, we can just have the mobile theme in the we can just have the admin theme in the mobile, and we can edit our site in the mobile as well. So you can see in Drupal 7, if I taken this screenshot from mobile, and if you can see in small screen, my Drupal 7 admin was like too much, I have to zoom it, I have to click, and it's not sure that we will be pretty much accurate in our task. So actually Drupal 7 theme, admin theme was not meant to be for the small screens. But in Drupal 8, right from the beginning installation, the theme is responsive. Your icons in the manage tool, in the admin toolbar, your icons will be shown in, your text of the icons won't be there. So it will just leave behind the icons, and your all the admin blocks which are horizontally placed in the desktop, they will flow to the vertical position in the small screens. And if we come little down, I've said that all the our blocks will be vertically aligned. Plus, it will just remove the unwanted, like least important data, like description of the module. We need not to have in mobile. So it will just squeeze that, and it will just bring the module name and just checkbox to enable that. And another thing for content editor, there is an awesome specific tool for there, and we can just edit our site from mobile. We need not to worry to go to desktop. We need not to worry to open our desktop. And we, and in most of the countries, content editor are adding the content through tablet only. So this was the niche, most important initiative which was taken in Drupal 8, and they made awesome mobile team. Another factor in this responsiveness is the tables. Tables were like, it was too much harder to adjust the tables in the small screen. I got lot of you can say UAT issues because of these tables, and they are not fitting properly in mobile. So we can, in Drupal we came with a new solution that we can just cut the least important column. And we can just show the most important table. As you can see in modules also, they're just using the same technique. Okay. So how we can do it? I'll just show in the demo. So I've built one view. Okay. And in that view, I have defined my format as a table format. So I've defined the fields, node ID, title, body, and this is my view page. And when I squeeze the screen, you see my body column especially, it's going to be too long. We have to scroll and scroll to get the line. So what we need to do, so in this case, I feel like my body field, it is not that much important to be shown in mobile. I just need node ID and I just need my node name. So what we can do, we'll go to the settings, and here we will get responsive image use case. So we need to set the priority, responsive table use case. So we need to set the priority as you can see. Yeah. So I need node ID, I need title in my mobile screen. But I need not to have a body in my mobile screen. So I can just give the priority low. And author field, I'll give priority medium. And I'll save this. So once we, I'll go to my page and reload it. So as you can see, I've just in my tablet viewport, I don't have author, and then when I went to my mobile viewport, I just don't have this body authored field also. So we can just skip, we can just cut some columns from our viewport. Yeah. Another factor of the responsiveness in mobile and in Drupal 8 is the HTML. So all the HTML tags, they are brought in Drupal 8. So all the new semantics and all the new form elements, date, email, telephone, all these are in the code. And fallback to this HTML. So some browsers are there which don't know about the HTML5 elements. So modernizer JS is included in the code. So they will have just fallback to this HTML5 element. And this is in the Drupal 8 core itself. So all these factors, why we are discussing about all these factors, responsive images, tables and all, ultimately they are leading to our performance. We want good performance, we want awesome user experience. And not only user, content editors also. So front-end performance, if you can see, why we are concentrating more on front-end performance, in desktop, your performance, it will take 85% in the front-end. Okay? It's depending on the front-end more than the back-end, your performance of the site. And in mobile, this use case, this case is going to be more interesting in mobile. Your front end is responsible 97% of the your performance. So how we can see in Drupal 8, we have image optimization, we have HTML.